Well, compliments to them folks at Twang, those guys and gals at Twang. Twang's coming, you're gonna see. We've got this really cool case, and inside the really cool case, ooh, it's very leprechaun-like. Parker Event Series. It's a Parker acoustic guitar. So we're gonna fool around with that today. Definitely needs new twangers, new strings, and got a little humidity thing in there. There's a thing in there to read. Hold on, I'm gonna cut and put it on the bench. So it's got that little plaque that talks about where all this stuff that's in this guitar comes from. Cedar, and then there's this wooden one which tells you that designed in the USA, assembled in China. Okay, cedar. This little thing, these two little, I guess that lets me into the truss rod. Let's have a look at the neck straightness and playability. Nice thick bridge that they've supplied, which is something good to look for, because then it can be shaved down if it doesn't play right. Let's have a look. Okay, so we're looking at the 12th fret, and we're looking at the space between the bottom of the string and the 12th fret. And excuse me while I twist the guitar and look at it under magnification, and then I'm gonna tell you what the number is. But we're gonna go with the, people have been asking me about this trick, the quarter. Well, it's not a trick, it's a guideline. 1/4 just sliding under there is really, that would be the best string playability you'd hope for. I don't have the specs for Parker, but I'm going to use the specs for Martin. So Martin says that this space should be 3/32 or 0.093. I'll make a little picture of that. That's the minimum that they would set it at the factory. That doesn't mean that that's the way it should be, but this one appears to be a little bit high, so let's just stop for a minute. I'm going to measure it. Yeah, we'll just disregard that. 3/32 is the minimum. 7/64 is the max. And 7/64 equals 0.1094 inches or 2.78 millimeters. And like I said, this is on the really high side. Now those are the numbers that we'd have anticipated for the fat E, the skinny E. It's slightly less, 1/16, the minimum as far as Martin recommends, and slightly higher for the maximum. Needless to say, this is just like really on the high top side of not playing very good. Okay, so let's just measure the relief now. Hold on. So I got my capo at the first fret, and relief is the amount of curve in the neck that lets the string vibrate so you don't have buzz. And I might have to go to Skycam for this. Let's just try that. Okay, so you saw I got the capo down at this end, pushing down on the last fret of the guitar, and we're measuring this at the 7th and 9th fret, and what I'm finding is it's about 15 thou. So I'm thinking we could possibly try adjusting the truss rod and make this guy a little more playable. And that's what we're going to try first. So let's see what's under there. Hang in there. Hang in there. Did I say hang in there? Hang in there. Okay, there's the truss rod adjustment. And I need something. How's this working? Oh, I hit my melon on the Skycam. Well, that's just perfect. So, righty, ink, ink, tighty, as I'm looking at it, you know. And I'm going to see what happens here. Oh, it's very tight, like as in really tight. So you get a little quarter turn there. You notice I'm doing this with the old strings before I put the new strings on, so I don't dent things and screw things up. So let's just try that again. Ideally, the relief, the space there, should be about 10 thou, 11 thou. It was 15. Now I'm looking at, see, that's just bumping in there. Now I'm looking at 13. So try 11 here. I think we can live with that. But we must measure the string height again at the 12th fret and see what happened when I pulled the curve out of the neck. Stand by for that. Yeah, so I spoke with the individual that is the owner of the guitar. And we're going to drop the string action a little bit by shaving the bridge saddle. So let's do that. I'm going to bail out of the Skycam. And do that. So there's the little piezo pickup in there. And I'm not going to be able to take a lot off this. This looks like it's been depleted previously. But pop it back in. Get in there, you. And make a little pencil mark. Where's my pencil? There it is. So this is like a really fine mechanical pencil. Okay. So, to get the string action to drop by 20 thou at the 12th fret, I have to take 40 thou off the base of the bridge saddle. So, using that really fine mechanical pencil and the calipers and all that stuff. Now, we could get more drastic, but that would require shaving the bridge itself as well, not just the saddle. So I'm going to jig this up the way I do it. You could do this by hand on a flat surface with a piece of sandpaper. I don't do it like that because I just want to get it done. So here we go. So I flipped it upside down and I'm going to use my little power sander to remove it. The brass strips are holding it in such a way that they're my stops so I don't peel off too much. So let's do it. We'll be right back. Okay, the saddle is shaved. Let's put the thing back together, clean up the frets, and put a little drop of oil on the fretboard. All that fun stuff. Hold on. Okay, so we're gonna put these strings on it. 12 to 53. And she should be good to go. So I managed to get her down to 5/64 on the fatty, 4/64 on the small E. I can't do much more, otherwise we got to shave material off the bridge itself so that the string angle breaks properly over the bridge. So that's going to be it, but it is quite playable and quite acceptable where it is. Let's make some sound. Okay, so acoustically, ooh, it's not bad. All these things for plugging it in. So I noticed here. There's this a blend thing, so I guess that's this pickup, I believe. Or is that the piezo? Again, a Parker P8EN acoustic guitar. Cool. Cheers, folks. Just wanted to get one last good look at the craftsmanship. Some nice stuff. Paca. Once again, cheers and happy holidays to everybody. And a big thank you to all my new subscribers. Everybody's joining up. I'm flattered. I'm flabbergasted. Okay, I got some other guitars showing up, and there'll be some more guitar videos. So hang on to your shorts. Smell you later. Cheers.